3-2 lead in the series, 110-107. We heard from Pop. Here's Mike D'Antoni.
And that's where you have to kind of battle it, and we did, and it was all the way down the wire. And again, you make a play, you don't make a play. We had good looks, and they had good looks, and that just happens. I'm fatigued than everybody. Everybody's legs, and 16 to 15 in the fourth quarter, everybody was tired.
Mike, how would you assess Simmons' job on James and what he gave them offensively as well?
Good. I mean, he was good tonight. Yep.
You've obviously been through a lot of battles against the Spurs in the past, and specifically against Pop and Manu. Is it kind of bizarre to still see him making impacts of playoff games after all this time?
Well, I figured that Manu at least have one or two good games, you knew that was going to happen. That's why he's a champion. He's great. He's been great his whole life everywhere in Europe and then over here. So, again, for them to beat us, they had to step up and did it. They got it done, and we didn't quite get it done. But, it's a long ways from being over. And we'll find our energy, and Houston's another story, and then hopefully we're back here and try it again.
You think of- Yeah, that game six will be Thursday night in Houston. Harden had a triple-double, also had 9 turnovers in the game. And Kawhi Leonard with 22 and 15 and not playing in overtime. And that's
the story of this game.
That's the story of the rest of the series.
No question. That's the story right there, because he's not able to play. This will be a wrap.
He's going to be all right.
Well, I'm worried, Shaq, because he didn't play. Come on, for him, as great as he is, not to play the last 8 minutes, I think they said.
We're going to get treatment tonight, treatment tomorrow. He'll be ready on Thursday.
Well, I just felt that he played after.
No
that.
Way he sits out this game.
He and gimpy. He didn't look hurt. There's a difference.
Right, yeah.
Well,
that's the reason he didn't put him in the game.
No, but there's a difference. But he was gimpy. Like, he didn't look hurt. Straight viewer point, watching it from the stands. Being a former athlete, it looked gimpy. It didn't look hurt.
If you're just gimpy and it's overtime, game five?
No, I wouldn't. I wouldn't, because Pop, this is, to me, and I had about 18 people text me, row in the back text me, and everything. Hey, what's going on? Why would he take him out? Because Pop doesn't care. He doesn't play the name game. He plays, if you're ready to play, you play. If you're not, you're not. That's why he sat guys on NBC games, ABC games, ESPN, TNT games.
Yeah, I don't agree with that.
Because he doesn't care about
that. No way Kawhi Leonard misses the next game.
Oh, I don't know what's going to happen. I'm saying I would be concerned, because for him not to play the last 8 minutes of a season, when your season's on the line, that would make me concerned.
And on the Houston side, and you talked about this. We watched that offense really stagnate there late in the fourth quarter and into overtime. Is that a result of D'Antoni plays 7 guys? Is there fatigue? Does that take you out of your game?
Well, even if you're fatigued, Ernie, you can start your offense sooner, because everybody knows when the shot clock's winding down, the advantage switches to the defense. You know he got to do something when it's 5 seconds to go. And I thought the Rockets played awful offense the last 5 minutes. I mean, they just gave it to James, and he just kind of dribble, and then tried to make a move. And you can see they start shading him. Chico says shade him left.
Chico, our head of security.
Well, first of all, he don't know anything about basketball.
Obviously,
why are you quoting
him?
Why are you quoting him?
Exactly. He's screaming in the back of the room like people listen to him.
He was right.
But because James Harden goes left 99.9% of the time. Everybody knows that. But I just, their offense became so stagnant, Ernie, and they didn't score.
Well, this was one of the things, Ernie, that when they said that they were going to move James Harden to the point at the beginning of the season, the fear was, well,
what if he does this?
What if he does that?
Yeah.
And what he just did.
And he has not done it all year in fact.
Right. And he has not done it. He was great and fantastic MVP type year. But this was the fear of what you thought could happen in those last 2 or 3 minutes of games, where he just held the basketball and they had no movement.
But I don't understand why they played the reason, 7 players.
I think the reason he held the ball, because, they weren't shooting the 3 ball well. So, when you're not shooting the 3 ball well, your number one guy, he puts it on the shoulder to take the score. But I agree with you guys. He held the ball too long, because, usually, when he dribbles, he goes somewhere and draw and kick. But he didn't do anything.
The last time I've seen a team play 7 players was in a fifth grade game against my Aim High team because the other three kids' parents couldn't play. They just brought the kids to the game. You don't play seven guys in an NBA basketball game in the playoffs because you should have confidence in more than seven.
Maybe
guys.
Find a few minutes somewhere for Decker or a few minutes for Harrell somewhere.
Sam Decker has played well all year. I mean, Sam Decker's played well.
Like I said, the reason you don't play guys is because their parents didn't play the dues.
You can't win an NBA. I think
dues for the team.
You can't
win. Maybe they didn't pay their dues, and that's why they get run. Yeah,
I don't think you can win an NBA game playing seven players.
Sam Decker's a pretty good player. He should be out there.
Montrezl Harrell can give you a five-minute break.
He can give Capella minutes.
You got the Harden that we're talking about. And
I think this was by design, not just because they held the ball down to the 10-second mark and then threw it to James.
Yeah.
So to me, it was like actually by design that they were doing this, which
in fairness, if you look at all James' turnovers, he might have got tired, but that's no way. They put him at a disadvantage and let him just hold the ball.
Give it to him with 10 seconds and go, okay, you make it happen for us.
No, all right, you got to go faster.
But that's the result of them not hitting shots. They're not hitting shots, or they're saying,
well,
James,
I don't know.
But Shaq, even if they're not hitting shots, James can get his own shot. He don't have to wait and make his move with 5 seconds to go. Oh, I mean, if they're not making shots, that's fine. But James can get a shot.